shout out to you guys. We are quite underrated, underestimated, you know, but we are slowly but surely getting there, and we're climbing, and we're being recognized for the things we do. So thank you very much. My first poem is basically an outcry about that. Yeah? Poetry is not dead. We're still here. We're still here. And lynching my tongue, words hanging from your mouths, crucify my craft. I am cross with a smug as I watch your conviction stand its ground, knuckles on standby, raising clenched vocal fists. You're stoning our rhymes with a mouthful of teeth, biting parts of our speech. Your tongues rolling up your sleeves, your blood is irony. Double standards degrading the hierarchy of poetry. A primary need in our burdened society, nailed to submission. But we don't bow that easy to bend the truth like the back of any book. Our souls are open, read between the mics, sessions, closing in on lies. We're slamming words against doors, refusing us our right to be spoken. We are contemporary poems, but universities think we're an unkempt language from the streets. So we're not Shakespeare. Our poems aren't good enough to teach, but we have healed. The chairs at our shows are filled with casualties of war. Our content is messy, because there is nothing academically neat about breaking when bodies are aching. Our audience transcends into one massive patient, wrapping our words around their heads like band-aids. Our words as transparent as x-rays to see through your dislocated bones, your malfunctioning souls. We're planting seeds, growing people big enough to speak, yet you claim that we're deceased, buried with the names of revolutionary men. I must be a phrase, exalted from their grave. Word and sound, help me explain. How can you say poetry is dead when poems hold our breaths and every line is a lung waiting to resurrect your dead sons? We are moving, growing in locomotion to keep your spirits growing. Yes, we are moving, growing in locomotion to keep your souls going. We are moving. We're moving. That's poem number one. Yes, thank you. So it is Women's Month, right? So this poem basically is also an outcry. Because our women are being murdered, you know? The hate crimes that we've experienced as a country are hurtful, and as a woman and as a black woman in this country, it kills me. And so, this is about that, yeah? There's a province, rape capital of the South African womb, where crossroads are angry at men who declare she had cigarette loose legs. They scaffed the 15-year stormbeam's last breath. Autumn leaves her ashy feet on a winter street that breathes heavy like TB. When the wind blows her body across the road like smoke, the tar coughs up phlegm to clear her skeleton from its chest. The summer sweats her death like granules of malaria on the pavement. The seasons are contracting fever by day. A chronic disease called rape is floating in the air, and it's worse than AIDS. The CD4 doesn't count yet, just the number of men you've slept with. Questions will feel like knives probing. Are you sexually active? Yes, will sound the alarm. The sirens will raise their frowns, but the ambulance won't come. In the private parts of our ghettos, there are cervical wars. Underwears are under attack. A city of cavity walls crumble from the drones you throw. Streetlights watch vaginas tear at the fence. There's a cycle of menstrual men bleeding women at their gates, where yards tell double stories of rape. On 1 acre of land, her body lies bent like crescent. No U-turn for the uterus. So the The gutters drain, not on a Nogwaza pelvis. Listen to her name, it's a peace sign getting stabbed at the end of its phrase. Her soul has reached a dead end in a town called Boysens. A neck, a dilapidated building, skyscraping statistics. Can you imagine the view from the windows of her soul? When Breda stopped, let her perpetrator walk over his sins like a bridge built on the breaking backs of women who stood like pillars against chauvinistic odds. You strike a woman, you strike igneous rock. We will burn these tombstones where it's slaughtered like sacrificial goats served to patriarchal gods who hold our bodies like oath at the temples of their groins. We're sworn to serve their testosterone. When the graves set the tables of hate, crimes are seated where bloody napkins wipe their feet on table mats, laying a cutlery of bones besides shovel-like spoons where bowls feel like tombs, craving bodies like you. When your skeletons get out the closet where gay pride is hung by gender violence, there are exorcists casting demons with their penis from the bodies of lesbians, queens dethroned from the earth. There are ghosts of girls clinging to umbilical cords in court, waiting for justice to be served. Dear Lord, deliver us like babies away from this morgue where mothers carry body bags in their stomachs. The child kicking in the rape capital of this womb could be you and you and you. The child kicking in the rape capital of this womb could be you, you, and you, and you. It could be either one of you, the child kicking in the rape capital of the South African womb. Could be either one of you. Whew. I'm ending it off on a light note, I promise. this poem was actually written in appreciation, you know, of all the amazing writers I've met on my journey. People have inspired me, people I've learned a lot from. But today we just tweaked it a bit, you know, to incorporate everybody and to celebrate everybody. Okay. This is to all the revolutionary minds I know. The ones changing the world, experiment at a time. You are doing words right when putting ideas down. You cross your legs in cursive. You sit like cliche. You stand like a pen, clicking its tongue across the stage as blunt as pencil. Sharpened too many lives, but still remain broken into pieces of chalk, surrounding your hearts like classroom walls in the school of an audience, anxious at their desks for the chapters in your breaths to snap their fingers out of apathy. Hug them like calligraphy, curling its arms around people to read them in stanzas from poems you've written in genres of speech. Building communities in sonnets takes over 14 horizons when your 15th line still hasn't saved a child. You feel like a helpless lifeguard, watching your inner man drown your sorrows in ink for the whole world to read. Your body like script moves like pages, vigorously flipped. Your pulse beats the time bombs were meant to tick, because you're explosives. Your names are riots of alphabets, hiding armies beneath your accents. You're rolling your tongues into AK-47s. You're smuggling guns in your grammar, typing bullets in your notes to shoot straight to the point. We're growing old. Our history is aging. The timelines have wrinkled into fiction, but it's up to you to keep the truth young, its youth. So, salute. Mandi Poefficient, thank you!